This is Dr. Bill Petok, a psychologist in Baltimore, Maryland. Does stress cause infertility? There is a link between stress and infertility. While we don't know with certainty that stress causes infertility, research has demonstrated that couples who report feeling good become pregnant at a higher rate than couples who report being tense and anxious. Similarly, women with higher levels of stress have lower success rates with IVF than those who have low levels of stress. Stress and infertility seem to go together. In fact, it is unusual for couples coping with fertility issues not to be stressed. You are pursuing a very important task, the creation of a family, and the obstacles to achieving that task produces stress for most people. Stress can affect your infertility treatment decision-making. It can lead to isolating yourself, which can result in feelings of guilt, shame, and regret. You can't ignore stress's effect on you when trying to conceive, because stress can disturb the unique blend of hormonal components that make pregnancy possible. So how do you cope with stress when undergoing infertility treatment? First, you can work with your healthcare provider to develop good coping strategies to manage stress that helps you feel more in control and improve your overall well-being. Working with mental health care providers, you can explore how to fortify your coping skills. There are specific stress reducer activities like aerobic exercise, walking, yoga, and relaxation training. All have an ability to improve not only physical health, but psychological well-being as well. Activities that help produce relaxed states such as guided imagery, journaling, and mind-body groups are also well-known stress reducers. Finally, self-help books, support groups aimed specifically at fertility treatment patients, and psychotherapy can all improve psychological well-being, thereby reducing stress. Stress reduction can help you evaluate the pros and cons of a particular course of treatment and make decisions that are in your best interest. Reducing stress is good for your health. While no one expects you to approach fertility treatment stress-free, finding ways to minimize stress while pursuing treatment can help. It helps to look for ways to reduce the burden of infertility treatments and medical protocols. This is true for both men and women. A support network of friends and family can be important. At the same time, these people may not know the best way to be supportive. In fact, their attempts to support you may be stress-inducing. We know that individuals who are told to just relax and they will get pregnant experience a great deal of stress. In fact, telling a loved one to be less stressed may make them feel as though they're causing their own fertility. Sometimes, friends and family need to be educated. If you are comfortable with the discussion, you could advise your family and friends to ask you how you are doing and allow you to talk. For many people, having an accepting listener is greatly appreciated and helps reduce stress. For these people, knowing that the best time to offer advice is when it is requested can be extremely helpful. Even though infertility and its treatment is more regularly reported on in popular media than ever before, many people have neither experienced it nor know what to do or say to friends who have it. It is possible to help them so they can help you. So to summarize, we know that infertility can cause stress that leads to anxiety and depression. Research has demonstrated this time and again. We also know that stress can make conception more difficult for men and women. While the exact mechanism how this works is not totally understood, it is clear that there is a relationship between them. Finally, it has been demonstrated time and again that stress reduction techniques, when employed on a regular basis, can improve conception rates. Here are the resources that you can access directly from your computer or internet-connected mobile device. ASRM has a short video on coping with infertility. Please be advised that it's several years old and some of the cost figures have changed. There are two national support organizations aimed specifically at fertility patients and those seeking to build families. Both of them have extensive libraries of materials that are patient-friendly and available at no charge. Path to Parenthood and Resolve provide materials developed by experts in the field. All of these materials are available at no charge. All of these are nonprofit organizations. Finally, if you want to find a mental health professional who specializes in the field of infertility, go to the website of asrm.org, find a member, and search for mental health professional.